Hi, with this video I'd like to talk about reading in CSV files into R, also talk about naming variables. Before we do that, we have to recognize that R needs to be told what directory your CSV files are sitting in. The default folder may not indeed be the folder where your files are, so you're going to have to change directories and point R in the correct direction. To do that, we go to File, Change Directory, my folder that I want to demo is deep in here, so give me a second. I found the folder, it's online data files. I'm going to highlight that folder and I'm going to click OK. Now at this point, R is pointing indeed to that folder. I can verify that by typing directory, left parentheses, right parentheses, and it'll tell me what indeed is in the directory. I can confirm, are those indeed the files? And they are. There are a bunch of CSV files that I'd like to read in. Now I'm going to focus in on a file called houseprices.csv. What's in that file are seven columns of variables, some numeric, some not numeric, namely labels for categories. But the key to know is that those columns all have header names. What I need to do now is name a data object, which is a data frame. I'm just going to call it HP1 for house price 1. I'm going to assign it. You can use an equal sign or you can use a left assigned arrow by doing a less than sign dash. Read.csv house, I need the double quotes, house prices.csv, close out the double quotes. Now R has a number of options here. Like I mentioned, if you have header names, you could tell R that, though the default in R is to assume you do have header names, but the option is header equals, if you don't have header names, then you're going to say false, but here it's true. These are CSV files or comma separated values files, so the separation is indeed commas, but we could have tab, delimited files, spacing, but to tell R indeed the specific type of separation, we can use the SEP. I'll put in double quotes, the comma, close out the parentheses, and it's done its job. Now I know in this case that they do have headers and they are separated by commas, so that I don't need to really add all that extra in some sense redundancy with those options. So if I were to simply type read.csv, houseprices.csv, I'm good to go. But bear in mind, remember, you need to have headers in there. If you don't, then it's going to accidentally read the first row that might be numbers as a header, and that's not what you want. Now if we want to look at what we have in there, one option is to type HP1, the data object, hit enter. Now there's about 100 plus observations here, so this is going to scroll by real fast. And we can see here that there's the data, 128 observations. If I were to scroll up, I can see the names of the columns, price, square footage and abbreviation, bedrooms, bathrooms, offers, brick, neighborhood. Another way to find out what the header names are, if you have somehow forgot, and what basically you have in the data set, is to use the str structure function, structure on the data object, HP1, hit enter, and there you can see that it comes back with some sort of executive summary of sorts. It tells you we have 128 observations of seven variables. It gives you the names of the variables on the left edge. Tells you that some are num, which is basically having decimals there, and integer being integer values, and then factor because of the yes, no, east, west, north. Those are really categorical kind of variables. At which point we can start proceeding with our analysis. Now, we might innocently say, okay, I want to get the mean of price. I know that there's a function called mean, so I'll type mean. I'll type in price. I see it above as a variable. And we get an uh-oh, we have an error. The problem here is that R is not recognizing price in the sense of being connected to the data frame HP1. You have to explicitly draw the sort of the arrow or connect the threads there between the variable name and the data frame. One way to accomplish that is to put the dollar sign tag. So I could type mean HP1, that's your data frame, dollar sign price. Now it knows price is in this data frame HP1. Hit enter, and we indeed get a mean value returned. Another option is to type with. With takes as a first argument the data frame HP1. And then we can give it the statistical function we want to do, in this case, mean on price. And indeed, we see the value of 130.4273. There are other statistical functions in R which give you an option to tell R where to look, what data frame. One is, for example, the LM, linear models, regression fitting function. So let's try that out. You can type out, I'm just giving it a name, an arbitrary name. I'll call it out1, it can be any name you want. Out1, I'm going to assign to out1 the linear model fit of price on square footage. Now, if I had hit a right parenthesis enter, it wouldn't know what price is, it wouldn't know what square footage is. If I had put the dollar sign in front of price of square footage with the HP1, it would have worked. But the alternative I want to show you here is that there's an option of data equals HP1, and that works for you. You can summary that linear regression fit, and there we go. There's even another way to deal with naming of variables, other than using the with command, other than tagging it with the data frame name dollar sign variable, or using the data equals in the LM. You could pull out the data values from the data frame and assign them to a specific variable object. So for example, I might type price. I'm going to use the same name. Now I'm outside the confines of the data object, so this is in a sense just an absolute new name. I'm going to assign to price the data values in HP1, and I know that those data values that I want to assign to price are in the first column of HP1. So I type HP1, and if you look carefully, that's a left bracket, not a parentheses, comma 1. That's the way to get to the column that we're interested in this case, the first column. Hit enter, and if I type mean on price, there you go, the 130.42 number is calculated. If I want to get the square footage one, again, I can give it any old name. I'm going to use the same name as the headers. Square footage. HP1 is the data frame, left bracket, comma, it's in the second column, so you got to know which columns the data values you're interested in are. You can use that structure to remind you. There we go. And if I, let's create a second regression, dump things into a variable, an object called out2. I'll do a linear regression fit of price on square feet. I'm not going to need to use data equals. I don't need to use the dollar signs or any of that. I hit enter. things seem to be working. Summary, out 2, and there we go. We have the regression fit. If you look in the working space, I'll type ls, left parentheses, right parentheses. It tells me we have 5 objects sitting in the working space. HP1, that's the data frame. Out1 and Out2, those were the linear regression results dumped into those objects. And price and square footage, the defined variables by pulling out the data values from the data frame and putting them into these objects. I'm going to remove them, namely the price and the square footage. You can see here if I type ls, they are all gone. We're back to basically square one. If I were to type mean, it has no idea what that variable is because it can't associate it with the data frame, indeed HP1. So there's a final solution that I'm going to provide for you in terms of naming variables, and that's called the attach function, ATTACH, attach HP1. And what that will do, I'm going to hit enter here, that will do is take the column header names and indeed attach them to those columns of data. Now, in a lot of introductory stats courses, like the one I'm teaching here, that's a simple solution. It's an easy solution, and it works. So, for example, you could see here if I type mean price, it works. If I do a linear regression of price and square footage, and all the other guys like bedrooms and bathrooms are all recognized straight up. So it's a simple, easy solution. Now you might ask, why have I wasted your time on showing you all the other ways to name variables? There are a number of R purists that would say you shouldn't really be using attach because it can run into conflicts, especially when you're doing analysis on many data frames or if you're doing heavy-duty programming where you have a lot of variables named. When you use the attach, you can run into conflicts when you have a couple different objects with the same name. So let me show you that. I'm going to read in. I have another type directory. I have another data set in my folder called houseprices_silly. Let me read that in. I'll read that into HP2. Read.csv. houseprices_silly.csv. Close it up. And there we go. Now let's take a quick look at what's in Silly. So I'm going to use a structure on HP2. And you see it's a single variable, 128 observations. All the values are minus 1,000. So just an absolute silly data set. Now you remember I attached the first data frame, HP1. So as a reminder, if I type price, there are the values that were in that original data frame. Now suppose I now attach the second data frame, HP2. Let's type price. We have it attached to the latest data object. And so we can't have this sort of coexistence between the two. We could have said HP1 dollar sign price, HP2 dollar sign price, and then it would recognize the two different price names associated with two different data frames. But you can see here the problem with doing an attach function. If you're having more than one data frame with a similar name, we can run into confusions and thus run into problems. So that's a forewarning. I will actually use attach consistently through the course that I'm teaching here as an introductory stats course because we're dealing with a single data set, doing the analysis there upon that single data set. I'm not so worried about conflicting issues. But as you mature and progress as a data analyst, that you're doing more sophisticated analysis, or if you get involved in R programming, then you may want to rethink the use of attach and consider the alternative solution shown earlier. Thank you. Talk soon.